grew up one of four children. I was the youngest of four girls. Even though I was surrounded by a lot of people, it was somewhat of a traumatic time for us in our childhood. I grew up isolated and lonely, and so music was a solace for me, and have always turned to music to find safety and to find security during a time where I really couldn't express myself. During my childhood, there were some really tough moments, and I smiled and I laughed my way through a lot of it, but if you looked a little bit deeper, you would have seen a child who was very broken, who was very isolated, who was dealing with a lot of anxiety and depression. I didn't feel free to express myself. Music was a way for me to do that. While growing up, I sang in grammar school, I sang in high school, I sang all the way through college. I've also sang in church. So I've been singing all of my life, but probably the most meaningful singing experiences have been singing by myself. I'm grateful for the gift of music because, again, it's a way for me to soothe myself. Music for me was a way to really connect. The artist gave me a voice. People like Karen Carpenter, Rainy Days and Mondays always get me down. And I would sing my heart out and nobody really knew that it really got me down. I was speaking my truth, but then I was still able to laugh and smile and be my expected self. And so music was really a way for me to deal with those emotions that I wasn't, I didn't really know what they were. I didn't know what to do with them. And so music was an avenue for me to express myself. I can breathe. I can be my true self. It's a recovery journey every single day. Every single day. I have to fight my recovery journey in order to be my best self, in order to be my productive self every day. If I don't practice my recovery tools, this is not the person that you would see. I would not be able to get out of bed. With the help of so many other people, with the help of my therapist, with the help of support groups, with the help of NAMI. So it's taken a team approach. And so I guess what I'm saying is I never want people to think, boy, she's got this thing licked. NAMI really, really helped me to come to terms with the fact that I'm living with a mental health condition, number one, and also to recognize that I'm not alone, and to also give me the skills to say, yes, I'm living with a mental health condition, but I can fight and I can win. When I sing at the slam, it will be a song of gratitude. It will be a song of thanksgiving. It will be a song of victory. We can fight and we can win. And so it will be a way to say thank you, and we're all in this together, and I love you. So that will be my message.
It's the heart Ericka Bailey, everybody.